Today we're taking a look at the Pimoroni Pirate Audio Headphone Amp. It's a compact, high-quality audio solution for Raspberry Pi. We'll unbox it and give it a test ride. Here we see the packaging, but let's take a look at what's inside. Here we have the Pirate Audio board, and it's pretty compact. Now, given the 40-pin header, as you can see, it would work with a Raspberry Pi 4, and it will work with a Raspberry Pi 5. But given the form factor, it's really designed to go with the Raspberry Pi 0. And because I wanted Wi-Fi, I've used the Raspberry Pi 02W. So let's remove this protective film and take a look. On the back, you've got the 24-bit digital to analog converter, 3.5mm headphone jack, and on the front, you've got these four buttons and the display, which will show track info when set up with Mopidy. As you see, Mopidy runs on a Raspberry Pi, has a web server, and plays music from LocalDisc, Spotify, SoundCloud, TuneIn, and more. You can edit the playlist from any phone, tablet, or computer using a variety of MPD and web clients. And Mopidy stands for Music Player Daemon. Now, besides the buttons and the display, why do you need this? What do you need a digital to analog converter for? I mean, taking a look at the Raspberry Pi 4, there is already a 3.5mm audio output jack. Well, I have used older Raspberry Pis on projects that needed audio out, whether it's for playing music or audio cues, and it was awful. You could hear the Raspberry Pi thinking. It was like having an old computer next to a shortwave radio. So external digital to analog conversion is the way to go, and here's the high quality option. On the back, we have the DAC, which is a PCM5100A, and the 40-pin header connector, and the four buttons on the front for playback control. To connect it, it's easy enough to align correctly because it's exactly the same size as the 02W. Now, assuming you have Raspberry Pi OS on your microSD card, you can set up the Pirate Audio software, including Mopidy, and you'll find the instructions on Pimoroni's website. Link in description. Let's power it up. Once you're set up and powered up, in addition to using services such as Spotify, you can copy music directly to the microSD card using software such as FileZilla. Now that setup is complete, let's take a look at the web interface. Here's Mopidy running. This lets us play music from local files, Spotify, and other sources. You can see the track information and the album art in the background. The buttons also work for playback control, but here's a tip, they're just GPIO buttons, so you can use them as well as the display for anything you want in your own projects. And that's it, a great little board for turning your Raspberry Pi into a high quality audio player. And because you can run the Raspberry Pi on a battery, if you have a portable battery and you want to go for a run, you just bring out your portable battery and off you go.